So I'm currently with Jess. You guys know Jess, one of my children, JK. We're about to go vintage shopping. What else is new? I feel like the last vlog, all I did was vintage shop. But you know what? That's what this channel is, and that's what you guys like. So I'm gonna vintage shop again. I just want to go into that painting and dance around in a dress. Oh my gosh, guys, look at this pink hamper. It's so pretty and it reminds me of Emmeline. I think she might have this, to be honest. But yeah, this antique shop is like, well, it's an antique mall. It's crazy. It has everything, like so many things. What's that lavender room over there? We should go check that out. So there's just a Louis bag casually chilling, and I'm pretty sure it's fake. So you know what? It's cute for pictures. Actually, never mind. No, it might be vintage real Louis because the price, it's actually decently expensive. So who knows? Oh my gosh, Jess, you should get it. $30 for a Prada bag. There's probably like Gucci or something. Is there more? There's Coach. Coach. So it's three Coach bags, a Louis, and a Prada. Guys, look at these two tiles. How pretty. It's like a bunch of like Marie Antoinette's like having tea or something. And then look at this bowl. It has like, I don't know if it'll focus, but it has like roses. It's like pink glass and it's super pretty. It's really heavy. This looks like Wendy from Peter Pan. It's a plate. It's so cute. My gosh, this vendor has everything girly in here. Look at that little cupcake tier, the lamp, the heart-shaped wicker mirror, and this lamp. I think I'm gonna buy this, guys. Look how adorable that is. I know Easter's over, but I always have like that springy style, the pastels. All the earrings and jewelry, and that little like earring box. That's so cute. It's our girl. Oh my gosh. Wow, what a good find, Jess. You could read all about her.
Guys,
oh my
God. I'm gonna get married, JK. But look at this vintage like veil and like this wedding dress. I wanna buy the crown for like decor.
You should.
A wedding veil, isn't that pretty?
Like, so pretty, decor? You should.
Where do you even put this on?
It's like a wedding veil with a tiara on it. It's adorable. I have like a vintage bathroom at my parents' house and I'm gonna do a bathroom tour there soon. So like I have my eye out for like vintage bathroom items and this is really standing out to me, like so adorable. Look at that little gem. It's a Lady Ronson one. How adorable. I keep saying that. How adorable, how adorable, how adorable. Guys, look at this hat. Oh my gosh. It's so pretty. I would actually wear this in like a photo shoot, I feel like. It's super girly, it's my aesthetic. It kind of reminds me of like Lily Pulitzer, like the colors. I don't know why, but I think this would look super cute hanging on the wall of my vintage bathroom.
I would say this is cute, but I don't know if it's gonna be haunted. So we don't know.
Look how pretty this wreath is. I want it so bad, but I'm not getting married, so like there's no reason to buy it. But if I was getting married, like I would so buy it. Look at all these feathers and like flowers. Oh my God, it's so pretty. I want it so bad. Oh my gosh. Look how cute this lampshade is and this lamp. It's beautiful. Either every vendor has the same damn bunny or this creepy bunny has been following us. It's so terrifying. We totally just saw this like 5,000 times and it's scary. It's always watching us. Whenever we like find it, the eyes are like facing towards us. That is so scary. Guys, I said yes to the dress. What's up with all these wedding things popping up everywhere? I want this dress so bad. I would get married in it. It's beautiful. And it has like a little headpiece in here. What's up with all these wedding dresses? Like, they're everywhere. Now, this is a cute little vendor, but wow. Hold on, I'm gonna hold it up.
Look at this.
It's so gorgeous.
Aww. It's so pretty, like the color and everything and like the gems. Let me see what the headpiece looks like.
Aww.
I probably, if I wore this, if I got married in this or whatever, I'd wear a different like kind of headpiece. Probably like something a little more modern with it, like a floral wreath or something. Not something like this, but I want it.
Guys, this pillow. I love it so much. Look at this tray and that one too. Easter greetings and it's sparkly. It's so me and Emmeline should have come here.
Look how cute. Pin money.
Nice mirror. Oh my God, what the hell is that?
The train's
coming. This very pretty satin bed jacket is in this box and it's only $20.
So I tried on the wedding dress. I love it so much. I like Cinderella.
So Jess got a priest and I'm gonna get married right now.
Look how pretty this is. I mean, it's pretty loose here and like I'd probably like change up the sleeves a little. And all the lace decals. I love it. So I get out of the bathroom from trying this on and there's a subscriber outside of the bathroom and asked to take a picture with me. So I took a picture with a subscriber in a vintage wedding dress.
Hi, Gab. Love you. Hi guys, don't mind the TV in the background. I was watching a Barbie movie, but I'm at my parents' house and I'm gonna show you guys what I got when I went vintage shopping earlier. I just took off all my makeup and put my hair up in a little messy bun. Yes, my room is a little different right now. I'm in the middle of rearranging it. This is the glass case that I got when I was with Emmeline. The only thing I have in here right now is this Breakfast at Tiffany's like face mask and earplugs. But some of the stuff that I bought today on my vintage shopping spree, I will be putting in here. These are the items I bought while vintage shopping today. I'm just gonna go through them a little bit and then once I'm done decorating my vintage bathroom, which might be tomorrow, I'll give you a vintage bathroom tour at my parents' house. So I got the adorable Lady Ronson electric shaver. It's so cute. It'll look so good in my vintage bathroom. I then got some more tea towels. Last time I went vintage shopping in my last vlog, I got tea towels. I'm addicted to them. They're so pretty and I can definitely find a place to decorate my room or bathroom or apartment with these. I also got this very pretty mint bowl. I feel like this is a pretty ring bowl. I've been very into rings lately, so I just feel like it's a cute little delicate bowl to put my rings and jewelry in. I went ahead and bought the adorable pastel flowers. I don't know what this is. I think it's just decoration. It's very Easter slash spring. I know we just had Easter, but like I always say, this is always my style, so I'll find a place to put this. I went ahead and got the turquoise hat. This is gonna be hung up on the wall in my vintage bathroom. I then got this pearl embellished sweater. I'm obsessed with the sleeves. It's like cinched around the wrist and then gets poofy around the elbow and up, which is my favorite look. I feel like I'm gonna be wearing this all the time this spring. I love like a good sweater that I could wear over here on the East Coast when it's still chilly, but it's beautiful weather. I got this mirror and I'm trying to put this on the wall in my vintage bathroom, but if that doesn't work out, I'm gonna put this in my Pink Wonderland bedroom. Hey guys, what's good? I then got this vintage change purse. I love vintage purses and I just feel like the strap is a lot longer than most vintage bags. It's a bunch of tiny pearls and I love when they close at the top like this. I then got this flower crown, which is like a really pretty sky blue with some gems in the middle of the flowers. It looks so pretty on. I love it. I'll show you guys like when my hair is down tomorrow. And if I forget, I'll definitely be having a photo shoot in this. It's so cute. I got the peach colored bloomers. They're so cute. I'm definitely gonna wear these to bed. I might put them on to go to bed tonight. They feel so comfortable. I feel like these would look so good under like a sheer nightgown or a sheer dress where you could see right through it. I then got this 1940s Vanity Fair nightgown and this is that silhouette I like again with like the cinched tight sleeves around the wrist and just a very pretty trumpet sleeve from the elbows and up. I also love that it gets cinched near the waist and there's buttons, it buttons up and there's lace. I just love this so much. Last but not least, my favorite thing I got today is this beautiful blush colored nightgown. It's so my style, like the cream lace, the silhouette, everything. It's so flowy and beautiful. I actually might wear this to bed tonight. Good morning, fancy babies. I just woke up and I'm wearing that nightgown that I showed you guys. It was so comfortable. I felt like a sleeping princess. It was amazing. And Lily just woke up to my little lazy piece of poo-poo. I've been calling her a cocoa bean lately because she's so chubby. Are you a cocoa bean? Are you a cocoa bean? Say, I'm a pretty famous cocoa bean. Oh. So this is what it looks like. I love it so much. Sorry if you can see through a little bit, but it's vintage, so I'm just gonna cover my tatas with my hair. And I think I'm gonna show you guys my vintage bathroom because it's all ready. I finished it last night, so let's go look. So this is my vintage bathroom at my parents' house. Hey again. Sorry if the fan's obnoxious. There's like a fan in here. Yeah, I'm gonna give you a quick little bathroom tour. I'll do like an overview again. It looks like that. You walk in and I have like this beach wall plug from Bath & Body Works. And I think it's like something coconut. I think it's copper coconut. I don't know. It's something weird. Then I have this picture that I've had since I was in a dorms. If you guys remember my dorm tour, I had this exact picture. I feel like it matches the yellow in the bathroom. I have this mirror with these two lights over here. You go down here and I have these two little holes like in the tiles, which is so cute. So I put this little towelette with a bow on it. This vintage card. I don't know if you guys remember me getting this vintage Easter card in the last vlog, but I got that and put it there. And I got my dried out flower bouquet that smells so good and put it right here, as well as the little tiny bunny. If you guys remember me buying these things, make sure to comment down below. And over here, I have the Lady Ronson razor, the vintage one that I bought earlier in this vlog, as well as the tea towel from when I bought those, and this tea towel from when I bought like the recent things. I also have my vanilla coconut hand wash, my Burt's Bees face wash. I have this little vintage dish with just some tools. I do have cosmetic scissors that should be in here, so I need to go look for those. But I also have my favorite lip balm from Lush. I have this little vase for like when I take baths and stuff, or when I give Lily a bath, I like to use that and pour it on her. A floating cotton ball. And I have another tea towel. Over here, I have my candlestick holder that I bought in the other vlog with a pink candlestick. I have this vintage pastel flower arrangement with my powder yellow gloves, and then some hair ties that shouldn't be there. I have these Bloom bath salts, this cocoa banana. Funny story, I was in Bora Bora and got a massage, and she heated up the coconut oil and it turned into this really pretty warm silky oil that she lathered all over me, and I fell in love with it. So I've been using this as a lotion replacement lately. And then I have this fragrance, this perfume that's made for Bora Bora only. Sorry if I pronounce it wrong, but I think it's called Cocky. I don't know. It's C-O-Q-U-I, and it's Per Umis Sanoka. Sorry, I can't pronounce anything, but it's a really good fragrance, and they sold that at the spa in Bora Bora. Over here, I have this lace fabric I got at Hobby Lobby, and I just used command hooks to hang it, and I tied it over to the side with a belt from one of my robes over here. I have all like my Victoria's Secret robes, and that's one of them. And I got this vintage hat yesterday and decided to hang it on the wall with a command hook. And over here is my Lush collection. You guys know I'm in love with Lush. This is the body bar, the lotion bar I've been using lately. It's a strawberry and it smells like strawberry shortcake. It's so cute. And I have the rest of my Lush collection here. Oops, the fan just turned off. And some Glam Glow face masks. Over here is just a cabinet where I keep some storage. I just want to show you guys this. How funny is this? I got this in the mail for I don't know why, and it says I love you from top to bottom, and it's toilet paper, so it's so funny. I've been like cracking up at it. I don't know why I got that. And then over here I have my bath bomb collection and Lily shampoo. We like take baths together sometimes. And then over here is my bathtub. I have like a shower rack up here. I love this pink reindeer sponge from Bath & Body Works. I'm obsessed with Christmas and like pink Christmas or like pink reindeer. That was a very retro thing they did back then. And this is what it reminds me of, like a retro pink reindeer. Down here, I have shimmering snow lace and Prince shaving cream from Lush. I love this stuff so much. So I'm obsessed with shower smoothies, and I have like two Turkish Delights, and then I have Dream Wash. They all smell super good, but Turkish Delights smells more like roses, and that's why I'm in love with it. I love that smell. And I also have pink marshmallow buttercream, which is so good. It smells like frosting and it's powder pink, so that's super me. I also have a princess soap bar that I haven't opened yet because it's so pretty, and a vintage flower that I put in there because this soap doesn't fit in the thing that holds the soap. I have a candle in this corner, which is crunchy pistachio vanilla. It smells so good. And then some
cream de coco shampoo and conditioners. I have more of a higher brand shampoo and conditioner up here, but I only use this on like special occasions. And then I use my Amika hair mask on my hair.
Stepping out of the bathroom, and this is a vintage bath mat that I got at an antique shop. So yeah.
Let me know in the comments down below if you guys like what I did to this bathroom. I know some of you might be confused. This is my parents' house. I have an apartment here in Pennsylvania and one in LA, which I'll be at in like 2 days. So I think my next vlog might be there or might be here. I don't know. And this is my parents' house. I'm here all the time. I love my parents' house. Why not be here if I have a room and a bathroom? So
hey, sweet peas. So I'm in my apartment and I'm doing some cleaning, and I just thought I'd take this moment to kind of just sit and talk to you guys, because I feel like this whole vlog, it was just like me doing things, and there are certain things I need to address and go over a little bit. So about 2 vlogs ago, I was telling you guys a story about how I experienced someone stealing, and I guess I was being really immature about it, and I was laughing about it, and I even vlogged her, and I thought I did the right thing sharing what goes on during my day with you guys. Like, I'm just an open book with you guys, and I don't like leaving things out. So when I was sharing that story with you, it wasn't me snitching on her to you guys. It was me just letting you know what happened. But in terms of me telling on her, I am genuinely sorry that I did that, one, because that wasn't any of my business, and it took posting that and hearing your guys' perspectives to realize that I don't have the best judgment out there. I've made mistakes, and I don't want to start anything by addressing it in this video. I just think it would be really stupid of me to not ever address it, because it was really fucking low of me, and I'm a dumbass a lot of the time. I genuinely just thought I was doing the right thing because it was a hefty amount being stolen, and I just wanted to make sure that I didn't have a guilty conscience experiencing a woman stealing thousands of dollars worth of Sephora makeup. When I opened up to you guys and I told you guys that I used to steal back when I was younger and in college, I never stole thousands of dollars worth of makeup, but that does not justify, because once upon a time, I was in her shoes, and that was very wrong of me. And sometimes it takes things like that for me to like to hit myself in the head and be like, you're so stupid. Like, she was probably going through something that was not your place to tell the whole world about it. So I went ahead and blurred her face, and I'm apologizing to you guys. And woman, if you're watching this, I am truly sorry, very sorry about the incident. But no, I'm not gonna go delete that vlog, because there were things that were going on in that vlog that a lot of you guys like and liked. So I'm not gonna delete it, but I did go ahead and blur her face. Yeah, I'm super sorry. And I'm just letting you guys know that it's hard. Like, everything you do is like in front of the camera, in front of a bunch of people. And I make dumb decisions too, because I'm human. You guys make dumb decisions too, but my bad mistakes get caught on camera, and sometimes my judgment is off, and that just sucks when you publicize it and then you realize, holy shit, my judgment was way off, and then you feel so embarrassed, and it's just awful. So I'm pretty impulsive when it comes to vlogs, since I upload vlogs once every 3 days. I don't have much time to literally sit there and be like, should I put this up? Should I not? All I know is that I want to get a video up there for you guys, and I want to satisfy you. And yeah, it turns out that I just have crappy ass judgment when I'm rushing to get a vlog up for you guys. So I'm super sorry about that, but I don't regret telling you guys the story time, because these vlogs are like as if I'm talking to my friends, and you guys are my friends. So if that actually happened and my friend came over later, I would tell them the story exactly how I told you guys. So yeah, that's my apology, and I'm sorry for being a crappy role model at times. Like, I really hope you guys don't become snitches because I'm one. I'm gonna work on that. Everyone has their problems, and that's something I'll work on for me and for you guys. That video clip makes me very disappointed in myself as a person. Don't be impulsive. Learn from my mistakes. Just watch what you do. Watch what you put online. All right, I'm not gonna talk about this too much. I'm gonna be careful on my decision making, and I'll be more sensitive, okay? Y'all, look at these bags I just got. They're so cute. I don't know if you guys know of the brand called Ecosusi, but I found them on Instagram, and I fell in love with their messenger bags. I have a 12-inch MacBook, so I thought these bags would be really cute to put my MacBook in. This one's definitely big enough to fit like a bigger size MacBook in here, but I'm going to LA tomorrow, so I think I'm gonna be bringing this bag, but I'm not sure. I think, or this one. This is the Ecosusi Vintage Messenger Bag, and I chose it in brown. This is the Ecosusi Vintage Satchel with a brown bow. They come in all different colors, but I'm just reading you guys like the colors from online in case you wanna get the exact ones. This is my Ecosusi Crossbody Messenger Bag in the color pink. This is my favorite one, but yeah, this is what they look like. They're really, really good quality. I'm gonna try to open it. Hold on. So it has like a long strap that you could wear over your shoulder. How cute. And it also has like a little handle. This is what the inside looks like. Oops. This looks like you would find it in a vintage store, so I'm
really fixed on which one I should bring as my carry-on on my flight tomorrow. So pretty. Oh my gosh, this is huge. That's why I kind of want to bring this one, because I could fit more things in this one. But the pink one definitely has my heart. Yeah, you know how like there's those ads on Instagram? Well, I saw these crossbody bags as like a little ad on Instagram and I clicked on them and they're so cute. They actually like are really good quality. I'll be linking these babies down below and my code is Gabriella, G-A-B-R-I-E-L-L-A, and it's a coupon code, so you'll get a good percentage off if you get any of these bags. My apartment is like a disaster right now because I've been all over the place, like from my parents to like my apartment to LA, from Bora Bora, but yeah. I'm gonna clean up. I don't know if I showed you guys my wallpaper ever in a vlog, but yeah, I got my room redone and it looks like this. It's so cute. Here's my little slime collection, guys. I have a slime collection. Yeah, I buy things on Etsy, so if you guys make slime, make sure to let me know in the comments down below what your slime account is, because I love slime. This is my favorite one. But it's so sticky right now. Oh my gosh. Oh, this needs more. What's the word? Ah, it's on the carpet. What's that powder stuff? Oh, borax. This shit needs more borax. Look at my hands. Oh my god. No, the carpet. I'm like all alone in my apartment. Get my carpet with slime on my hands. Hold on. Oh my god, I don't want to throw this away though. I don't want to throw my slime away. Oh my god. I'm just gonna have to throw my hands under the sink. Oh, yeah. Goodbye, slime. This is all. Oh my f-ing god. Oh my god. I ruined the slime. It got stuck on my hands, so I had to pretty much destroy it and put my hands under the sink to get it off. So like, I wasted all of that top half of the slime. So now I know not to use it until I put some damn borax in it. I have like my day to myself today and I'm like relaxing. Like this never happens because I leave for LA tomorrow, so I'm just doing whatever. Like I was watching Shameless up there and like, it's so awesome to just chill. Like, I really haven't done this in so long. My hands are still sticky. It sucks. I'm gonna go get some coffee or something. Sorry if this vlog's like super long. It's just like, or boring. It's just like, I'm home alone and Colin's working. And this is what I do. I get slime stuck all over me. I'm wearing Colin's boxers and like the slime is still stuck all over my leg and it's like all over his boxers and it looks so f***ing wrong. Oh. So my Southside Serpent things came in the mail as well as the purses and I am gonna go get some no-so glue so I could put the Southside Serpent snake on my leather jacket from Riverdale and then the Southside sign there and the Southside sign here. What do you think?
I'm a Riverdale fanatic, look.
So I can't find no-so glue anywhere in my apartment, so I'm gonna go run to Michael's and pick up some no-so glue, which is right by Colin's work, so I'm gonna pop in and say hi. And yeah, I'm gonna get a coffee because that's also by Starbucks, so yeah, come run errands with me now. Guys, this is my new favorite song. Like, Nikki is all about it, that I'm all about Halsey right now. Like, that's her favorite singer, so I think it's hilarious that I'm, like, all about Halsey right now. That's like Nikki being all about Ariana Grande, which you know would never happen. So this is hilarious. This is, like, finally the moment where Nikki and I, like, agree on something. Michael's is so pretty, but I only came here for no-so glue, so I can't buy any of this stuff. I came here with one mission. I think this is it, the liquid stitch right here, and this is like a smaller version, but I think I'm gonna get the bigger version because I have a feeling I'm gonna be doing this a lot. Like, I don't know if you know what this is, but it's like sewing, but without the needle and thread, it's just like really insane glue. So, yeah. Look how like springy these candles are. It's Camellia and Sweet Pea and Freshwater Pearl. Wow, Camellia is a very pretty name. But yeah, those are so pretty, especially Freshwater Pearl, like that's unique.
So I just glued these on with my no-sew stuff right here, the no-sew liquid stitch. Right now you could see some of like the white sticking out. So it says it dries clear, so I'm gonna have to wait a little bit to wear this, but this is what it looks like overall, and I'm super excited to wear it.
Hey guys, so it's time to go to bed now, and I'm currently chilling in my vintage closet because it's just so cozy and it's my favorite place to like edit photos or videos or whatnot. And I'm just catching up on editing some Instagram pictures. If you guys don't follow me on Instagram, you totally should. I have it linked below. And yeah, that's it for this fancy vlog. I can't wait to see you guys in my next fancy vlog. I'll be in LA, and I love you so much, and I'll see you next time. Bye.